House of Ruth, Maryland has been helping women and their children escape domestic violence since 1977. They have established themselves as one of the leading nonprofits in the country that helps rebuild lives, bring domestic abusers to justice, plus helps end a vicious cycle of violence through advocacy for victims. Joining me this morning to talk about how they do this and how you can get involved is Janice Miller, the Director of Clinical Services. Good morning, Janice. Welcome to Maryland Perspectives.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
When a woman calls you for help in getting out of an abusive situation, what is the first thing you do for them?
Well, the very first thing that we do is we check for safety. So we want to know if the person who is calling us is safe right then and there. And once we've established that it's a good time to talk, then the next thing that we do is we start by believing. We believe what victims tell us because the research has borne out over time that when women disclose intimate partner violence, when they disclose sexual violence, they are by and large telling the truth. So we start by believing what it is that they're saying, and then we talk with them, we have a conversation about what it is that they're looking for, and then we try to provide them the services and resources that they need in order to make good decisions about what their next step is in dealing with the abuse that's in their life.
And the services that you offer are varied, and you have a lot of things that are going to help women in these situations. So let's start with your emergency shelter. It's grown over the decades. How many women and children can you house right now?
So our emergency shelter, which is located in Baltimore City, is pretty big by the standards of shelters. Our shelter has 23 shelter bedrooms and 6 transitional housing apartments,
Wow. Which
means on any given day that we can house somewhere between 26 to 30 survivors of intimate partner violence on site, and that translates to roughly 180 to 220 families over the course of a year.
That's fantastic in respects that you are giving these people the help that they need, but it really sucks that you have to do that for so many people.
I'm hoping that someday I can put myself out of a job, but until that time, we want to make sure that any victim who calls and needs that emergency assistance, that there is someone there for them, somebody who can really be available to just listen or to guide them or to get them into those emergency type services.
Now, I included children in this because a lot of times they're caught in the middle of a violent situation. They're either being abused physically or mentally. So what do you do for the kids while they are staying with you?
A lot of times survivors will call us because the children have either intervened or they've been inadvertently injured in the process of physical altercation between the abusive partner and the victim, or sometimes just because the children themselves are being abused by the abusive partner. And we know that all children are impacted by living in a house with trauma. So whether there's physical violence or not, children know that abuse is going on in the house. So we want to make sure that when children are staying with us or whether they're coming to us just for counseling outside of a residential program, that they are getting the same messages, which is nothing that you did or didn't do caused this abuse.
Right.
So we do that through our counseling programs. We do evidence-based trauma reduction therapy with children. We do groups that focus on how to stay safe when there's abuse going on in the home and trying to help children identify who trusted adults are in their life, who they could go to for help. We talk about how children can call 911. We also provide in our residential program a licensed child care program and a developmental preschool program so that while those children are staying with us, the very youngest children, they still get that structure of a preschool program. They still get that support, gives the parents a break so that they can attend workforce development or go to work or go to school programs, and really gives the children a sense of security while they're staying here and helps build that resilience. And the other thing that we do for children is we just try to have activities that are fun and engaging so that they can have a sense of normalcy while they're staying with us.
And that's a big deal. It really is, because they're in a whole new place. And to give them some structure, I'm sure it just has to put them at ease a little bit. Now, of course, stopping intimate partner violence, the best way to do that is to intervene before it even starts. And that's kind of hard to do. Mm-hmm. But you have the Gateway Project. Explain what that is and how it can stop future abuse.
The Gateway Project is our abuse intervention program, and it was really developed with the population that we serve in mind, so Baltimore City's population. And when abusive partners are in court, they can be assigned to come to the Gateway Project instead of going to jail. So once that court-ordered referral comes in, then the individual will go through a 28-week set of classes with other individuals who have also been court mandated, and they can learn about the dynamics of abuse, about the cultural messages that help to reinforce their behavior, or how they can create more positive and healthy relationships with their partners, and really think about where the responsibility for abuse lies and how they can be part of the process of breaking that cycle of abuse, both for their partners, their future partners, and for their children who have been living in that situation.
There's a lot of legal things you can do also to protect a family. So how can House of Ruth help with legal services to help keep the family protected from an abuser?
I think legal services are really key to helping survivors stay safe. And even before they get to House of Ruth, if someone is experiencing intimate partner violence, they can go to a commissioner 24/7 to get an interim protective order on the weekends or the after hours. And then they are usually given resources about House of Ruth. Someone could come directly to House of Ruth Legal Services and get a temporary protective order, which can order the abusive partner to stay away, temporarily remove them from the house. They could identify that there are firearms in the house which might need to be removed. The attorneys can advise survivors about what their legal rights are, what the options are within a protective order. They can also then represent survivors at the final protective order hearing to, you know, just provide support and the best representation and advice possible for individuals when they're really going through quite a traumatic experience.
Oh, yeah.
And may have to be facing their partner in court.
Well, and I tell you, those red flag laws, when Governor Hogan put those out there, I stood up and went, yes, finally, because getting arms out of abusers' hands, it's very important.
Yeah, we know from Jackie Campbell's work that having a firearm in the house and threats to kill are really, really highly correlated with lethality of victims. And so those extreme risk protective orders are an excellent tool for victims to really be able to maintain safety, because if they suspect that that is a danger or a threat, or someone else suspects it's a danger or a threat, it's an opportunity to really remove those firearms. A general protective order can also order firearms removed from the home, but the extreme risk protective orders are an extra added opportunity to do that.
If a woman is in a violent situation and she needs to escape, what is the number to call?
Our 24-hour hotline is 410-889-7884. And like I said, that is available all times, all days, all nights, holidays, weekends. Anytime somebody wants to call, there will be a trained counselor there to talk to an individual, assess for safety, and try to figure out what those next steps are.
How can 98 Rock listeners support your organization and the women that you help?
The very first thing that I always tell people is that when someone comes to you and says that they are experiencing violence, you know, just acknowledge that they are experiencing the violence. Start by believing that victim. And after you are able to acknowledge that violence, then express concern and express care for them. I am sorry to hear that you're experiencing this. No one should have to live that way. I am concerned about your health and safety and the health and safety of your children. And then beyond that, we are really not asking the public to do more in that situation than just connect a victim or survivor with an organization like House of Ruth, like the National Network, National Hotline, to really get them to the expertise that they need. Outside of that, I think every individual has a responsibility to speak out against violence. We know that 1 in 4 women are experiencing domestic violence, and that means that somebody that you know is probably in a domestic violence relationship. When you speak out against intimate partner violence, when you don't tolerate jokes about intimate partner violence, you're sending a message to that victim that you are somebody who could help get them to safety. When we speak out, even if we don't think that people around us are a victim, we are telling people that we are an ally in this cause.
And what is the website address where people can learn more about intimate partner violence and about your mission and saving women's lives?
Our website is www.hruth.org. And on that website, you can find out about volunteering. You can find out ways to donate, both material goods or financially. You can also find out about what our programs and services are and learn more about how you can best help to end intimate partner violence.
Janice Miller is the Director of Clinical Services for House of Ruth, Maryland. I'll make sure I get the links up on our website, 98online.com. I'll include that phone number as well. Thank you so much, Janice, for talking with me this morning about the important work you're doing in helping women escape abusive and intimate partner violent situations.
Oh, you're welcome. I'm so happy to have this opportunity.